Mamboni, good morning. Thank you, Lorraine, for responding. Welcome in our today's session. Today's class. It's good to see Mwamboni today. I know she's been away. Welcome you, Mwamboni. Mamboni, I want to see you or hear from you. If you have not connected your mic, it's okay. I hope you will, so that we can want. Mamboni, I can see you connected. If you can talk, if you can type, fine. Now, today we look at the next topic on performance management. If someone has a question on our previous class, I would wish you bring it up. If you have any question on our previous class, please let me know. Any comment, any question for our next class, our last class, or previous class? Mamboni, Lorraine, anyone else who has joined? It seems you are okay. Our last class, we defined performance management. Then we defined, generally, we defined performance management in different ways. Then we looked at something else, and that is we looked at the roles of supervisor during performance management. We looked at principles of a good performance management, or that which influences performance management. And we also looked at the advantages and disadvantages of performance management. Today, we look at a key area where we are going to study on the performance management cycle. After the cycle, we'll wind up with differences between performance management and human and performance management and performance appraisal. So, if you look at the screen, which I believe you can see, I really wish to confirm that Mwamboni is with me. Mwamboni, please say something or type. It's good to hear you people, or even see typing. That means we are together. Munira, welcome. Confirm that you've received my welcome remark, Munira. Thank you, Munira. Mamboni, are you fine? Are you okay? Chage. I. Lorraine, could you know how Mamboni is doing? Munira, is Mamboni fine? She can't respond. Could she have be having a challenge on the background? Just confirm that you also can hear me and see me. confirm. Sorry, had some interruption. I'm very sorry for that interruption. Confirm you can now hear me. I hope you can hear me. Thank you, Munira, for that confirmation. Can you hear me, Laureen, Munira? Derek, it's good to see you joining us. I hope you can see me, you can hear me. They had some challenge with connection. That sometimes happens, sorry for that. So some are calling, they just want to find out what is happening. Laureen, I hope you're with me. Derek, how are you? Welcome, Derek, and welcome the rest of us. So I want us to go to what we have for this day. And we are looking at performance management cycle. And our main objectives are two of them. One, to describe performance management cycle. And two, to differentiate between performance management and performance appraisal. Now, as we get here, we just want to understand what is performance management in terms of the circle? What about the difference between performance appraisal and performance management? We are going to get to that after we've looked at performance management cycle. A cycle is that which takes us round. You start from one point and you end it at some point. So that is what we have in performance management. Performance management is critical, and according to a handbook for measuring employee performance, performance management is the systematic process of, is a systematic process of one. Now, these points are key. If you can see my screen, you would see there are points or there are terms that are labeled in bold. Those bold ones are what is going to be taking us through the cycle. Those are what I'm going to emphasize on as we move on. Now, when you look at the first one, we have mentioned that according to a handbook, this is a book that takes us on performance management. According to a handbook for measuring employee performance, performance management is the systematic process of Planning, number one, planning work and setting expectations. Number two, continually monitoring performance. So there is monitoring. Number three is developing. Number four is rating. And finally, rewarding. Just to go through them one by one, the first one is planning. Planning is very important. Looking at planning, we have each one of us have got their own plans. In organization, the supervisor should involve employees in coming up with performance management plans. The supervisor should establish measurable goals that align to organization's strategic and operational plans and should consult with his or her employees when coming up with the goals. So what I expect from my supervisor, if I'm in an organization or where I work, I expect that my supervisor engages me, the supervisor sits with me down, and we talk about the plans. Just like you would sit down with your parents and tell them, Daddy, we have been told to come home, or Mommy, or your sponsor, the person responsible for your fee, guardian, whichever name. Then you talk and tell them, we have been told to come home, and our next course of action is we are going to go online. Then you sit and discuss, what do you mean by this online? How long will it take? What is required? Is there some money implication? Or what do you expect from us from home? Then you tell them, this is what is required. It's required by this timeline. And this, when I do it, I'm going to finish my studies at this time. If I don't, I'm graduating next year. If I do it, I'll graduate this year. Then I have time to go for attachment. You see, it has got a lot in terms of planning. The way you plan at home is the same way you plan while you are in your organization. I have to plan. I have to do what we call lesson plan as a lecturer, your teacher, so that I know when I get to my class, where do I start from? I had to plan myself so that when you get to the portal, even if you don't find me, if there could be some delay, then you get there, you find there is the introduction to our topic. Then after the introduction, you find there are notes. Then you'd find there is audio. So it makes my case very easy. And that is what I am referring to here. So performance management is very critical in each and every organization. It must be planning must take precedent. Always in life, we are told that failing to plan is still a plan. But this plan now is planning to fail. So failing to plan is planning to fail because it's still a plan. That's why in each organization, planning is important. And at this planning stage, the supervisor should explain to employees the expectations. What are your expectations as a supervisor? As my supervisor, what do you expect from me? What are the targets of the organization? What are the plans of the organization? So that will make the work very okay, very easy, and very smooth. The next one, after planning, you move on to monitoring. You can only monitor what has been planned. You can only monitor what has been planned. And therefore, the supervisor should observe employees and should observe them as they progress. And this should not only be when the progress review is due. I should not, let me give it to, let me give it an example with the case of learning. Where I will only give you exams, think about it that you'll only do exam once. You do your first semester, second, third, fourth, fifth, until the final semester. Like now you're in the final, then your exams are only set during the final. I don't know how many will be conversant with that. that you'll only do your exams at the end of the sem at the end of your study, not semester. Semester one, you just read. Semester two, you read. Three, then the exam comes at the end. I'm sure some of us also will have a challenge, but some of us may like it. I may not know, except if you confirm. So it is important that this is done on a continuous basis throughout the period. This will give an opportunity to your supervisor to come up with some adjustments, to come up with some reviews, to come up with some corrections, and will help the employee to improve and help enable the organization realize the desired outcome successfully. And this will be for the benefit of the department and for the benefit of the entire organization. If the supervisor finds out that if the supervisor finds out that there are some unacceptable performance that is exhibited by the candidate or with the employee, then the supervisor would advise and give a way forward. After that, we have developing. The next step is developing. The supervisor should determine from a continuous monitoring whether employees need additional development to achieve their assigned responsibilities. Looking at this, it is important that employees grow or develop from one stage to another. The employee should grow only if the employer is willing to support. Because you may want to grow, but the willingness is not there. So the willingness should be there. You must grow. In fact, to me, I would say you must. You cannot join an organization with your diploma and you'd want to be comfortable with your diploma all through until you retire. You need to grow. And looking at this further, you'd find that in the organization, you can have various ways to develop your employees. And generally, I consider them, I know it is part of the session we are going to do in employee training, but generally, I would consider them as on the job training and off the job training. So I would consider on the job training, and I would also consider off the job training. Now, on the job training is training that is done to employees who are working in the organization and during their working hours. Off the job is a training that is offered to employees while they are away from their workplace or their working normal working routine. If it is to be done in the organization, then it has to be a case where you've stopped working and you concentrate on the training. That is off the job training, however, because all of us are doing the unit employee training and development, and I'm the one going to take you through. We will be doing it or looking at that together in our next class, and hopefully should be our next topic. That is on development or developing. Then after developing, we have rating. After development, there is rating. Now, in rating, you as a supervisor should use the knowledge you've gained from monitoring the employee performance during the appraisal period so that you can compare employee performance against their standards. There is a performance, there is the standard. So it is important that you use the knowledge gained while you are developing your employees. Now, when you get to monitor your employees, then it means that there is some observation you came up with or you identified. That observation should not be taken lightly. The observation can be used to develop employees. Then after you develop them, now the monitor the rating takes place. You can rate them. What is the target and what is the outcome? So that is where we talk about developing employees. Now, when you're looking at this, or looking at this rating, we say that the rating should not be one that surprises employees. If it is surprising them, it means they were not being involved. But if you are having continuous review all through, then you will agree with me that with continuous review, you can tell what you're going to have at the end of it all. If it is in an organization, you do cut one, you do cut two, cut three, you keep doing them, you will know how you are performing. You will even predict the overall outcome. But if you are not doing cut one, cut two, cut three, even me, I may not tell where you can fall or where you may be when the time comes for your exam. So that is very important for us moving forward. When rating has been done, as I've mentioned, remember that final rating should not be a surprise to employee, particularly when the supervisor and the employee have had numerous performance discussions during the rating period. So if you've had numerous discussion sessions, then there should be no problem. Lastly, in that cycle is rewarding. In this case, the supervisor should take meaningful distinctions when granting awards. And I want this to be clear. When you're awarding employees, please ensure that you are very clear to the employees you are rewarding. Ensure that the employees are well informed and everything is done the right way. Now, when you're awarding employees, award in a very fair way, because this performance management will be used to support compensation decisions. So as you are awarding employees, please be very objective with the award. Appreciate employees. One challenge with performance appraisal, or in the limitations of performance appraisal, you'd find that one of the limitations of performance appraisal is that the rewards or the awards are rarely given, and if they are given, sometimes they are not objective. So when that is sorted out, then it makes things work out very well. With that done, we have got the differences between personnel management and human resource management. Now, I want to look at this differently. And because the differences will come in, I want to first of all mention what performance appraisal is. That is when I will give the differences very easily. So in the differences, which I'm going to share, not really differences, I'm not going to share differences, but I just want to share so that I mention briefly on what performance appraisal is before I go. Let me see if it is sharing. Okay. I'll briefly go through this because we still have some time, and because we were one topic behind, let me mention on what performance appraisal is. But I want to go there if you are quite okay and you're fine, you can confirm that we are together in this. Can I get a confirmation that the cycle is okay, it's clear from my students? The students I'm missing. Who is this missing? Lillian is not here with me. Who else is missing? And I expected them to be here. I hope they will join. They'll join. Just a confirmation. All right. Thank you, Tasley. Monera, Lorreen, Derek, Mwamboni, if you manage to get away to text, because I can see your mic is now connected. I want to move on. If there are three more who one more, fine. This is okay. That's okay. Now, let me go to performance appraisal. Performance appraisal. I hope the screen is also clearly visible. I hope you can see. So, performance appraisal. check if they will be all right. Oh, thank you, Mamboni. I really wanted to see you, and it's good to see that you've confirmed and you've typed. It's good. So all my students are active. That's very encouraging. Thank you, Mamboni. I have seen Lorraine, Derek, Munira, Taslim all confirming that is all okay. Performance appraisal is a very important area in an organization. Our performance appraisal is a systematic evaluation of an individual with respect to performance on the job and individual's potential for development. Just to repeat, performance appraisal is a systematic evaluation of an individual with respect to performance on the job and individual's potential for development. And that is one definition. Okay. Measuring, evaluating job-related behaviors. And outcomes to discover reasons of performance. And at the same time, how to perform effectively in future so that employee, organization, and society all benefit. So if you look at these two definitions, one thing we should agree on is that performance appraisal is systematic. Performance appraisal is formal, and it is concerned with evaluating job related behaviors. So there are job related behaviors, and these job related behaviors, we are going to look at them. But I like the case where we're talking about to ensure that employees perform well. They perform well and they are performing well for the benefit of the organization. They perform well for their own benefit. And they perform well for the benefit of the society. Going to when I perform well, I know my duties. I will not even affect my society or the neighboring or where we are negatively. That is why performance appraisal or my appraisal is important. Now, the objectives of performance appraisal includes one, to maintain records in order to determine compensation packages, wage structures, salaries, or salary increments. So when you're doing performance appraisal, you should have a focus on looking at employees' salary, looking at the review of the salary or the wage structure, or if you can increase their salary. That is number one, to maintain records in order to determine compensation packages. That is number one. Number two is to identify the strengths and weaknesses. To identify the strengths and weaknesses of employees in order to place the right employees on the right jobs. So that is again very important. When you look at that, then it means that your strengths and how you're performing and help you strong and not remain weak. To maintain and assess the potential present in a person for further growth and development. They grow in the organization and they don't remain in the same level. The next point is on the next objective, or the third objective. Is it the third one? The third one I've mentioned, the fourth one, to provide feedback to employees regarding their performance. So that again is very important. I can see my screen share has a problem. My screen share has, my webcam has locked. I'm not sure if you can see me. My video seems to have a challenge, but the screen is clear. So maybe someone, if you can see my video, you can confirm. If you can see me, you can confirm. If not, I have sense. Let me try if I can adjust it. Okay. So looking at that, we have mentioned to provide feedback to employees regarding their performance and related status. The number five, to serve as a basis for influencing working habits of employees. And finally, to review and retain promotional and other training programs. So all those ones are very key areas as we look at the performance appraisal. To review and retain promotional and other training programs, to serve as a basis for influencing working habits of employees, to provide feedback to employees regarding their performance and related status, and to maintain and assess the potential present in a person for further growth and development. So performance appraisal is very important. Performance appraisal is important because let me give a clear outline. When you're looking at performance appraisal, I would take, for example, you did an exam in semester two, you get your results, then you sit and ask yourself, or even as you started the semester in semester two or semester one, you set a target that this unit, business studies, I want to get this, economics, I want to get this. Then when the semester is over, you sit and ask yourself, is this really what I wanted to get? And you may not even wait for end of semester. It could start from CAT or the class assessment. You start from there and ask yourself, was it okay? I targeted to get 10 out of 15 for my first paper. But was that, is that what I got? Sometimes you'd want so, but then it doesn't work out as you expected. So that is what we mean by performance appraisal. If you are targeting 10 and you got 12, then the question is, was the paper too easy? Or is it that you gave your best? You gave yourself much time? What is it that you can tell us about that scenario? That is what I'm talking about as far as this is concerned. And then still, in the same case, I just also emphasize on this, that performance appraisal should not be a way to feel intimidated, to discourage you, but it's a way that should help employees grow. So employees should always grow from one level to another. That's why when we know your strengths, we maximize on them. When you know your weaknesses, we help you overcome so that you be a stronger person and you be more of benefit to the organization. And therefore, to wind up, then we were talking about in our topic two, we were talking about the differences between performance management and performance appraisal. If you look at the differences, I want to make the differences clear by just doing a recap of performance management is and performance management is. Now, performance management, if you can see here, anyone who is on, the audio is on, can talk. To confirm that you're seeing what I've shared on the screen and read for us that. Anyone who is on and wish to read for us the differences between performance management and performance appraisal? Anyone who can talk, whose microphone is on? Lorraine, can you? Samira, can you? There is no response. Mwamboni, can you? Or Taslim?
Yes, I can.
Oh, please.
Okay, differences between performance management and performance appraisal. The terms
then
performance
management
and performance appraisal are sometimes used to synonymously, but they are different. Performance management is a comprehensive, continuous, and flexible approach to the management of organizations, teams, and individuals, which involves the maximum amount of dialogue between those concerned. Performance appraisal is a more limited approach, which involves managers making top-down assessments and rating the performance of their subordinate at an annual performance appraisal meeting.
Okay.
Can I continue?
Thank you so much. So it was that is the general part of the differences between performance management and performance appraisal. We have said that it is a comprehensive, that is performance management, a comprehensive, continuous, and flexible approach to management of organizations, teams, and individuals, which involves the maximum amount of dialogue between those concerns. When you look at performance appraisal, is a more limited approach, which involves managers making top-down assessments and rating the performance of their subordinates at an annual performance meeting. So that is when they do it. Now, when you're looking at this, the performance management and performance appraisal, now the differences here, as you can see, is that performance management is a joint process through dialogue that involves dialogue. But performance appraisal is a top-down assessment. Performance management is a continuous review with one or more formal reviews. But performance appraisal is an annual appraisal meeting. If you look at performance management, the ratings are less common, but performance appraisal is full of ratings. So it's the rating and rating and rating. Performance management is flexible, very flexible approach. While performance appraisal is monolithic. It's one-way approach, very rigid in itself. We must just do things as they are always done. Performance appraisal, its main focus is on quantified objectives, the listed objectives. But performance management is beyond the objectives. It focuses on values. It focuses on behaviors. So that, again, is very important. And lastly, the second last is that performance appraisal is often linked to pay. If your performance was 80% and you expected 70, then your salary is going to be reviewed. If yours was 40 and you expected 50, you are not reviewed, or you are not paid, the salary is not reviewed, or you are paid less. And that discourages employees. And imagine later we are going to look at even the performance appraisal errors or issues that may make performance appraisal effective. And sometimes it may not even be beyond you, or it may be beyond you, yet your pay is not reviewed because you didn't meet the expected target. Performance management is less likely to be directly linked to pay. Very less likely. And lastly, performance appraisal is bureaucratic, complex, and involves paperwork. You know what bureaucracy is? It must follow this step, this step, next step, the rigidity in itself. It's step by step. We don't have to jump. We don't have to excuse ourselves. But performance management documentation is kept to a minimum. So documentation is not that much. And finally, performance appraisal is owned by the HR department, while performance management is owned by line managers. So that is where the difference is. Personnel department handles all about performance appraisal, what performance management all line managers, relevant managers are put in place, and they carry out their tasks effectively. So I have, if you're keen, you find I've mentioned we've done topic two and part of topic three. Next time I'll combine topic three and four so that we are moving together as per the timeline, because we had missed our first session because of challenges, I believe, with us joining the portal and following together in our class. Any question, any comment? Please don't leave, as I also take your attendance for those who are present here. Someone who has a question or comment from what we have learned today, or maybe you'd wish that we proceed. I'd wish to get that confirmation also. Maybe someone wants us to proceed. Any comment, any question? Any comment? Okay, I'm informed that we proceed. Okay, fine. So I would still want to proceed because of the request. Then now go to topic three. Still topic three. I want to share with you topic three. So be patient as I share topic three notes. Anyone with a comment can still give as I link you to the notes. I think I'm now there in the notes. Let me just share them. Let me share the notes with you. I'm sorry that some challenge. I'm getting back. That's getting you back so that we move on together. I was sharing on performance management and reward. That's what I'm sharing. Just confirm that you can see. Okay. Confirm you can see the screen now. If you look at performance management, as I wait for confirmation, Agnes, how are you? Agnes, how are you? Monera is requesting that we proceed next time. Well, there was a proposal that we proceed. Agnes, it's good to see you. It's been a long time for you not attending our sessions. So I hope you'll continue attending now. Interact with these colleagues of yours. They're very, very good students. Interact with them. Mwamboni says, my slides are not clear. Yeah, because I've used Word. I should have used PDF. Okay. Correct that in our next session. I'll correct that. So the advantages, because of some of the requests, Munira, please be patient so that I look at the advantages and disadvantages of performance appraisal. Just be patient briefly. It will not take long, and for the benefit of also Agnes, who's joined us. Now, what is the importance of performance appraisal? One, they provide a document of employee performance over a specific period of time. Performance appraisal provided document of employee performance over a specific period of time. So we'll know how employees performed after a given period of time. Number two, they provide a structure where a manager or supervisor can meet and discuss performance with an employee. And this is something that's critical to me, that I would sit down with my subordinates, or those who report to me, and we discuss their performance. But I would sit down with my students, and then we ask ourselves, where did you get the challenge? Can we help? Is there help that we can bring on board? That is very important. Number three, performance appraisal allow managers the opportunity, or give managers opportunity to give employees feedback about their performance and discuss how well employees' goals were accomplished. So how did you manage it? Others were not making it, but how did you manage? They provide a structural process. So again, performance appraisal must have a process where you clarify expectation. And we are going to look at the performance appraisal process, where expectations must be clarified, where you have to discuss issues with your manager. And again, they provide a structure for thinking through and planning the upcoming year and developing employee goals. And this can also motivate employees if supported by a good merit. If performance management is done objectively, sorry, performance appraisal, if it is done objectively, employees will be motivated. And lastly, we have the disadvantages. In the disadvantages of performance appraisal, in the disadvantages of performance appraisal, we have some of them. I can see someone saying cannot hear me. I want a confirmation that you can hear me. Confirm that. Oh, thank you for the confirmation. That's fine. Can you see me at the same time? Not readable error, some error there. Need my webcam. Let's see if it's going to link. Okay. So some of the disadvantages is that if not done right, then you will find that they can create a negative experience. Employees will not be happy. They will be discouraged and may leave the organization. Performance appraisal are very time consuming and can be overwhelming to managers with many employees. If you have many employees, you may find performance appraisal becoming difficult, becoming overwhelming. So that again is an issue with performance appraisal. They are based on human assessment and are subject to rate errors and biases. I've seen cases or had cases where students saying, Malimo, you gave this person and me, you didn't give me. Why? That happens. That is the performance we're talking about. They are done by human beings. So some people may be like, oh, Malimo, you gave this person, didn't give me. What happened? Why? How comes? You are not fair. I have had such cases, but not many, maybe one or two. But then after clarification, then the satisfaction comes on board. So it can be subject to errors and biases. At the same time, it can be a waste of time if not done appropriately. Imagine going through all the performance appraisal process, and then you find that you have wasted time. And that is one thing that each and every manager must not allow. Somewhere we defined performance or human resource manager, and we said that human resource manager is a person in charge of others and is responsible for timely and correct execution of actions. So time is critical and correctness is very important. And finally, they can create a very stressful environment for everyone involved. Environment that may be created there can be stressful for everyone involved if you are pushing, you need records, you need, because we've said it's monolithic. It is stressful, it is rigid, it's bureaucratic, and then therefore, the environment can be very stressful and employees may not like it at all. So that is on performance appraisal. Next time, we'll be looking at the steps involved in performance appraisal. Today, we have looked at very critical areas where we have discussed on the performance management cycle. We have also discussed on the differences between performance management and performance appraisal. We further looked at the advantages and disadvantages of performance appraisal, the meaning of performance appraisal. We've also looked at the objectives of performance appraisal. Maybe you can hear your views or your comments. I've not confirmed that you people have gotten bundles. Lorraine, do you confirm that? But I want to hear your comments on this. Those who are able to talk, I'll allow you to turn on your mics, unmute, and then talk. Those who cannot talk and can type in the public or private chat, you are allowed to go ahead as we move on. Agnes, are you able to talk? I'm moving in ascending order, or the way your names appear in the on my screen, Agnes. Okay. Derek, are you able to talk or say something? Question, something that is not clear, concern? I'll skip Lorraine, being our class up, she'll talk last. Munira? Mwamboni? Taslim, I can't see your mic on. All right, anyone? Lorene, or anyone? You can type, you can just talk. You're free. Thank you, Taslim. You can unmute, then you can talk. Taslim, you can unmute, then talk.
Oh, sorry, I don't have anything to say.
Have you gone through the notes we had before? That
Yeah,
we
I've
did.
got.
What about the video for our previous class? Did you access it?
I have problems with accessing the video, but notes napitia.
Audio?
Audio nasikiza pia.
Iko sawa ama iko na shida?
Iko sawa.
Asante sana.
Ati chase bundles. Hakuna bundles.
Lorene will respond on that, but there are bundles. Did you take your give your phone for whitelisting? For whitelisting by Safaricom. Sorry. Let me hear from someone else. Let me get to know if these people confirmed. But there was a whitelisting by Safaricom of your phones or your lines. I want to confirm if someone has got the bundles or has the information on the same. Taslim wasn't aware. Any comment, any other comment on the same? Anyone who has gotten the bundles? If not, I will get to know that later. Any other comment or question? Please remember that after this, you go to the portal. We still have some 1 hour, 30 minutes in the portal to finish. So there are tasks, there is audio that is already there for you. Go through it. There is also a journal discussion, you'll find it there. Do them, the chat, so that I will grade your work. At the same time, I'll be marking the attendance every day. So Agnes, I know, I'm not sure, I'm assuming you're working. Our assignments will remain in the portal all through up to tomorrow or after tomorrow, or some may end tonight. So that is to make sure that if you are not a full-time student, you can still be catered for. Full-timers, I expect that you work within this time so that after this, you go back to the portal, do the tasks that I've already posted there to ensure that you move on safe and move on together. What else am I leaving out? I'm just waiting for Lorene to finish responding. Maybe this confirm. This could be that you've not gotten the bundles. Otherwise, I know I would have seen some people live. So if that is the case, I'll be following up with HUD still. And also your research project, I'll be following up so that I confirm your supervisors to you when you start reaching them out to ensure that things move on seamlessly or move on smoothly. So those two I'm following. If the bundles have not been sent, I'm following them. All right, thank you, Lorene. Now, sometimes there's a challenge. Yeah, there's a time that I broke. There's a time that I was a challenge. So that one is noted. Be patient, Lorene is still communicating. The connection problem, yeah, sometimes that connection problem comes. Though I've experienced that connection challenge today, other days it's not been this way. All right, so find out on Lillian, whatever it is. So I want to thank you all for turning up, and I'm looking forward to see you for our next unit tomorrow. Wish you well and have a good day. If someone is willing, wants to say something or to communicate with me after this, you can talk on the portal or after this, I have no problem. On. Thank you. I've read your comments. Those are very encouraging messages. And even the concern for one another is very encouraging and very grateful. Always be concerned about your brother, your sister, and make everyone feel comfortable. Let's always be one and united. Thank you all. Stay safe. Ensure you have your face masks and put them on. Some of us hang them. Please ensure you put it on and you know how to put it on, and then ensure you also wash your hands. All right, so I wish you well. Have a blessed day. Let's meet next time. So thank you. Good.